Hello world and welcome back to the RPA Champions channel, the place where we automate the future with no lines of code. Today we are diving into something truly amazing, building our own very own AI assistant using amazing tools from OpenAI. Imagine having a personal assistant that's not just smart, but AI smart, an assistant that can automate your work, that learns, adapts to do things that you can only dream of. That's what we are going to be building today. Maybe a little bit of an oversell, you are going to be the judge of that by the end of the video. Whether you are a seasoned developer or just a tech enthusiast, by the end of the tutorial, you'll have the fundamental knowledge to build an assistant that could revolutionize the way that you work, play, and innovate. Buckle up and grab your favorite beverage and let's get started. And if you haven't done so already, hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss any more automation and AI action by the RPA champion. GPT has served us great in creating different pieces of content like business plans, proposals, letters, posts, and generating all kinds of different content. Now, let's imagine that we can have our GPT do different actions. These are what assistants are. OpenAI has made available to anybody with a subscription plan to create and use different assistants. In the Explore category, we can see all of the different assistants that are available currently by OpenAI. Soon, there is going to be a store where we are going to be able to sell our own assistants. Therefore, learning the skills right now and learning how to build complex and useful and knowledge-based assistants is a very crucial skill to have right now. And also being early in the game is going to give you a competitive advantage compared to everybody that is going to come afterwards when they're going to be seeing the success of these different solutions deployed on OpenAI. This is going to give a birth to a creator economy focused on creating the best AI data-driven applications. Now, let's build one of our assistants ourselves. I have created different assistants that do all kinds of different things, from crypto trading to a Starfield space advisor. To give you an example of what we are going to be building, let's take a look at this crypto trading expert. This is a trading bot that I have configured to access different pieces of information and also make different API calls. Different API calls that can have data trends and data information currently in real life so that it can make accurate real-time decisions based on the information that I'm pulling via APIs. So you can imagine that we are creating an assistant that can interact with the internet, interact with different actions, which are these API calls that are going to be doing different things, such as provide information about all currencies available on Coinbase, or information such as, or for example, retrieve market chart data for a specific cryptocurrency against a currency over a specified number of days so that we can have insight on a specific currency. In addition to that, I have uploaded different documents that are reports and predictions of different cryptocurrencies so that the bot would take all of this in consideration. In addition to this, there is a prompt that has been generated that I have fine-tuned to make it work to my needs. Let's try this solution and see how it works. I'm going to ask it, what can you tell me about Bitcoin price in the past 10 days? We can see that it is calling a custom action that we have here. So it has taken our question, it has made sense out of it, and it's calling the API coin Jacko. So if we go down to our actions, I have several API coin Jackos. It is calling this one that is retrieving the specified cryptocurrencies for a specific number of days. And this is going to be the information that is going to be extracting from this API call. In addition to this, we can see that it has managed to talk to this API and has retrieved the price from the previous 5 days. Now, building this might seem very complicated, but we can use ChatGPT to create this structure. Once we find an API that we are interested in, we can ask ChatGPT by just providing it an example to create a code structure that we can just copy and paste. Let's create our own assistant from scratch and see how we can do all of these amazing things. It is very easy to create our own assistant. We can use the text interface to create our own assistants and kick things off. So we're going to be creating an assistant that is going to help us create the best YouTube videos ever. Once we have submitted the first command, what ChatGPT Builder is going to do, it is going to configure an initial prompt that is going to put into context the GPT. Once the first query has executed, if we go into the configure, we can see that there is already an initial prompt and some information has been added already. Now, if we continue with our chat, it is going to complete all of the remaining fields. And as we message and as we talk with it, it is going to refine the initial prompt. We can also see it right now that it has triggered DALL-E and is generating an image for our prompt. So after a few interactions with the GPT, which is a continuous question and answer process, that after every question, our configuration changes. Not only our initial prompt that we are using to set the instructions for the GPT, but also the conversation starters as well, and the description of what our GPT model does. So let's give it a go and see what it does. Deep dive into scripting on automation video. So it is going to provide me a step-by-step for this exact purpose. So what I have managed to save right now, I have managed to save time of writing a complex prompt for putting GPT into context and having it answer specifically for what I needed to create. It has created something that is very specific to the kind of content that I'm going to be creating and that I'm using. To enhance these capabilities, we have other things as well. We have the ability to upload different files. When uploading different files, make sure that you use proper names in the titles of the files. It is going to make it simpler for the GPT to interact with those files. In addition to that, when adding a action, we can select different actions, such as, for example, we can take this JSON example, we can copy and paste this, we can open a new tab, we can search for a list of open APIs. If we want to test this functionality, we can type in whatever kind of API we need. So for example, like if we're building a crypto finance, we can find all of different APIs here. These are APIs that work right out of the box without any configuration, any further configuration to the API key or so forth. However, you also have the ability to add an API key. Therefore, you can pretty much use any API you want. Not only APIs that retrieve information, but also APIs that do things such as scheduling a Google Calendar or doing any other actions like that. So we would get one of these APIs, such as this one right here. If we click on it, we can see what is the output of this API. And we would take this structure right here that we are using as an example from the JSON file. We would copy this, and then in ChatGPT, we would ask it to transform the following code that is the example that we want, and also add the link of the URL that we want, giving an example of the output data. It is going to create the code that we need for the action that we are going to be using right here. So if we get the code that has been generated right here and we copy it into ChatGPT, we are going to see that once we click outside of the schema area, there is going to be a new action available for us that we can test inside of our test functionality, and we can see what kind of results we are going to be getting from this API. So we are going to set this to allow, so it is going to make this call. So it is doing this get cryptocurrency data. It is doing different actions. It's making the API call, and it has managed to make the API call and retrieve all of this information. So right now we have added to our Video Virtuoso the ability to interact with the CoinCap crypto markets finance data so that it can provide information in real time about cryptocurrencies. And like that, you can use it for any other API, giving your bots an incredible power. However, be careful that there are a few things to keep in mind. Make sure that you work a lot on your prompt. Your prompt has to be an iterative process. You're going to be constantly be improving your prompt, so don't get into the mind frame where you're going to be just setting a prompt and letting it be. This is going to be a constantly evolving prompt. Why? Because you're going to be adding documents and adding other calls, but you're going to see soon that once you start cluttering your bot with different information, it is going to have a hard time picking the right information for you to use. Therefore, it is going to be very important to set a right prompt to reference whenever you need to use a specific kind of document or whenever you want it to behave in a specific way. Once we have created our bot and we are satisfied with our bot, we can publish this bot, make it available to everybody, to only us or only people with a link. Now, if once we publish this bot, we are going to give it everybody the ability to see it. And this is going to be soon available on the shop from ChatGPT. And creators that create these bots are going to have a revenue share considering the amount that their bot is being used. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you have learned something about creating and automating your tasks by creating an assistant or a copilot. I truly believe that right now we are living in an era of copilots and assistants where AIs are going to be working side by side with us to help us automate the majority of the tasks that we are doing currently. Right now is the right time to upskill your skills, so don't waste time and start learning automation right away. If this is the kind of video that you like, please leave me a comment down below, because I'm planning on creating more automation videos that leverage AI solutions and not only RPA. Thank you so much for watching, and I wish you a great day.